Sarge, Barbara Bailey, Katie Brandt, Dr. and Mrs. John Casey, Janet Purcell Avedy, the intentions of Dr. Laura Brandt, the intentions of Ronald Lampard, the intentions of the McCarthy McMahon family, special family intentions for Mark Capel and Ryan Curtis Baker. Our gallery
sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet, until her vindication shines forth like the dawn and her victory like a burning torch. Nations shall behold your vindication, and all the kings your glory. You shall be called by a new name, pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken or your land desolate, but you shall be called my delight and your land espoused. For the Lord delights in you and makes your land his spouse. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder shall marry you, and as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, there are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. To one is given through the Spirit the expression of wisdom. To another, the expression of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, mighty deeds. To another, prophecy. To another, discernment of spirits. To another, varieties of tongues. To another, interpretation of tongues. But one and the same Spirit produces all of these, distributing them individually to each person as he wishes. The word of the Lord.
There was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does your concern affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servant, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water." So they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, "Draw some out now and take it to the head waiter." So they took it. And when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine, without knowing where it came from, although the servers who had drawn the water knew, the head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves good wine first, and then when people have drunk freely, an inferior one. But you have kept the good wine until now. Jesus did this as the beginning of his signs at Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory. And his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Well, weddings are joyful occasions. We get together to celebrate the union of two families, the union of two lives, the union of two bodies into one flesh. And a big part of the wedding celebration is the food and drink. Can you imagine being at a wedding that runs out of food, or even worse, runs out of wine? Running out of wine sounds like a bad night for everyone. Now let's be clear, getting drunk is a sin. Reason is a gift from God, but when we're drunk, we're unable to use our reason, and we reject the gift of reason that God has given to us. Drunkenness makes us incapable of virtuous acts, and it makes us incapable of charity towards others. It makes us incapable of knowing right from wrong. But when used in moderation, wine warms our hearts and brings us together. As the beginning of his signs, Jesus turns water into wine. In John's Gospel, Jesus' signs and miracles are referred to as signs. John calls them signs because they convey deeper spiritual meanings. We can question why Jesus would choose this as his first sign, as his first miracle. I mean, why not cure a sick person or bring someone back from the dead, like we see him do later in the Gospels? Why change water into wine at a wedding? A closer look at our readings will help us understand and answer this question. Throughout the Old Testament, there's a continual marriage analogy. God is depicted as the groom who wants to marry his bride Israel, his chosen people. The prophet Isaiah writes, "For the Lord delights in you and makes your land his spouse." In the time of the Israelites, this was a new way of thinking. There were many religions and many gods, but Isaiah preached about a God who desired to have a personal relationship with his people. A God who delights in his people, who wants to make them his spouse. He wants to enter into the most loving possible relationship with them, his people. Isaiah writes, "And as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you." The creator of the universe delights in us, his creatures. It brings him great joy to be in a relationship with us. Now, any reader of John's Gospel was aware that God wanted to be in a relationship with his people. The wedding imagery in today's Gospel reminds the reader that God desired to marry his people. It reminds us how much God loves us personally. But the wedding analogy is not the only symbol that's used in today's Gospel. John writes, "On the third day, there's a wedding at Cana in Galilee. And the mother of Jesus was there, and his disciples were also invited." Mary and the disciples were present, and it was on the third day. For us, this should ring a bell. It should make us think of the resurrection. Jesus rose on the third day, and after he rose, he told Mary and the disciples to go ahead to Galilee to meet him there. Jesus' first sign of turning water into wine at a wedding is one of resurrection. True, he's not bringing anyone back from the dead, but it's still a life-giving miracle. Jesus is giving life to the party, true, but more importantly, Jesus is giving life. He's revealing himself as a life-giving source, the one who gives life. When Mary realizes that they're running out of wine, she goes and tells Jesus, "They have no wine." This is a beautiful reminder that Mary, our mother, is always looking out for our best interest. She's always ready to intercede for us to Jesus. When the spiritual wine of our lives begins to run short, Mary goes to Jesus and asks him to give us more wine. She asks him to give us the spiritual wine that raises our hearts and our minds to God. So how does Jesus give life to the party? How does he reveal himself as a life-giving source? Mary tells the servers to do whatever he tells you. This is a reminder that in order to be given new spiritual life, new spiritual wine, we have to cooperate with Jesus. Jesus doesn't simply create wine out of water by himself. No, he works with the servants to create wine. He takes what they already have and he works a miracle. Not only does he create wine, but he creates an overabundance of wine. When we bring what we have to God, no matter how small it may seem, when we do whatever he tells us, He gives us new life, abundant. He creates new spiritual wine in our hearts and raises them to God our Father. Jesus desires to work with us, to bring us to God our Father. St. Augustine says that God created us without our help, but that he cannot save us without our help. When we cooperate with God, we're given new life, eternal life. We are renewed spiritually, emotionally, and physically in our everyday lives. We become resurrected with and in Jesus Christ. On the morning of April 22nd in 1903, servant of God Elizabeth Lesueur entered the Church of St. Peter in Rome. She went to Mass in the Chapel of the Blessed Sacrament, and later on, she would write about her sacrament of receiving communion, of receiving the Eucharist, coming into communion with Christ. She says, "The triumphant Christ, the eternal Word, who was as man, suffered and loved, the one living God, took possession of my soul for all eternity in that unforgettable moment. I felt myself renewed to my very depths by him, ready for a new life, for duty, for work intended by his providence." Our God is a God who wants to have a personal relationship with us, and he offers himself to us in the Eucharist. So as we come together to celebrate Mass, to celebrate the life, death, and resurrection of Christ, we're reminded that his body and blood give us new life. We're reminded that in God, we are no longer lost or forsaken. We're reminded that we are his people, and he is our God. I believe in one God, Father, I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, one begotten Son of God, born of Father before all ages, God from God, life from life, true God from true God, begotten, not made, begotten, not made, begotten, not made, gathering our prayers and petitions into one, we offer them to our loving Heavenly Father.
As we recall the wedding feast at Cana, may the Lord multiply the good wine in us through our prayer and works of charity and service in the community. We pray to the Lord. For Pope Francis' prayer intention for the month of January, for all those suffering from religious discrimination and persecution, may their rights and dignity be recognized, which originates from being brothers and sisters in the human family. We pray to the Lord. For God's blessing on the people of Cuba, Iraq, Syria, and Afghanistan, as they struggle to secure rights in the face of persecution and opposition, we pray to the Lord. For God's blessing and healing of all victims of clergy sexual abuse, and for healing in our church, we pray to the Lord. for protection of our community from the latest spike in the coronavirus, and for healing of all who are sick, including those suffering with COVID. We pray to the Lord. For our deceased loved ones, and for the recently deceased, including Barbara Bailey and James Clapmeyer, we pray to the Lord. We now pause to add our own intentions in silence. We pray to the Lord. Please join in saying our family prayer, which is on the prayer cards in the pews. Loving and faithful God, through the years, the people of our Archdiocese have appreciated the prayers and love of Our Lady of Prompt Succor in times of war, disaster, epidemic, and illness. We come to you, Father, with Mary our Mother, and ask you to help us in the battle of today against violence, murder, and racism. We implore you to give us your wisdom that we may build a community founded on the value of Jesus, which gives respect to the life and dignity of all people. Bless parents that they may form their children in faith. Bless and protect our youth that they may be peacemakers of our time. Give consolation to those who have lost loved ones through violence. Hear our prayer and give us the perseverance to be a voice for life and human dignity in our community. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Our Lady of Prompt Succor, hasten to help us. Mother Henriette de Lille, pray for us that we may be a holy family.
Loving Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear these prayers and answer them according to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us all sing together song number 827 in the hymnal, the red gathered hymnal number 27.
my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrament is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we have lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
Amen.
celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. As we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Francis Xavier, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing hope. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Gregory, our Bishop, Sheree as assisting bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your home. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you in their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
our communion song can be found in the Blue Spirit and Song of the Lord, number 365, You Alone, number 365 in the Blue
Lord, hold me, you alone I want.
Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the announcement. The rite of enrollment for First Holy Communion has been moved to Sunday, February 6th at the 10 a.m. Mass. The Archdiocese of New Orleans will host a silver wedding anniversary celebrated for couples who have been married for 25 years. This will take place on Sunday, March 27th at 3 p.m. at St. Joseph Church in New Orleans. If you wish to register, contact the parish office by this Tuesday. Season 2 of the Chosen miniseries on the life of Jesus will be shown on 4 consecutive Wednesday evenings in St. Joseph Hall, beginning January 26th and then continuing February 2nd, 9th, and 16th. Complimentary meals will be provided, but you must pre-register for a meal. See the flyer and email us for details. We have our annual thank you party for parish volunteers on Saturday, January 29th. From 5 to 8 at St. Joseph Hall. There will be food, music, fun. So, and the list of volunteers are in the bulletin that we will be thanking. Way too long to put the announcements, we'll be here till tomorrow. So we want to thank everyone for that. The school and parish office will be closed for the Martin Luther King holiday Monday. Our chapel will remain open, however, and morning masses will be as usual. Please stand for the final blessing and dismissal. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. St. Michael the Archangel. May God be with you. By the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits, who die by the blood of the
sinners. And as we go forward, let us all sing together song number 537, number 537 in the Red Gathered Hymnal, Glory and Praise to our God.